I'll get it soon. I'm about to have it there. Alright, so at Pennsylvania Outdoors Unlimited, we eat everything that we shoot, so I'm going to show you today how to cook some duck. These right here are freshly killed duck. We killed them this morning. We have the breast meat right here, and what we did was we took the breast away, and what we're going to have to do, you're going to have to tenderize these, because these have a little more miles on them than your average chicken. So see how this goes. Got to take a piece of plastic so they don't splatter and just kind of hit them. The reason I'm using the back of a hatchet because we don't have the proper tenderizing equipment available at camp here, but anything will do. And this has the right weight. I think that'll do a pretty decent job right there. It's really nice and soft now. Probably going to cut a lot more like a filet mignon steak as opposed to a really hard piece of duck. So anyway, we'll beat all of these and then we'll go on to saute. Alright, for the next step, after we tenderize our duck, we're going to have to pull out some of the cutlery and chop these ducks, saute them into small pieces. Just like so. And while we're doing this, we're going to just make sure they come in small strips, and then we're going to end up sauteing them, sticking them in the pot here, or in the pan here, and frying them up. And that'll remove any pink inside of the duck, and also remove any of the blood. Hopefully, and just cook them the whole way through so that they're completely 100% ready to eat. Here we go. We got our duck cubes now. It's still a little bit bloody. It's hard to get all the blood out of ducks, especially when you're shooting them in the cold and when you're shooting them in the shotgun shell. But that's why we're going to saute them, and that will cook all the blood off. So we're going to stick them right in this pan, which we should probably turn on. In this pan, got a little bit of olive oil on the bottom of that, and we will commence frying or cooking. All right, so now we're just put a little bit of olive oil on the duck, and we're going to cook the blood off. As you can see, we're starting to do that a little bit. This brown stuff at the bottom, we'll end up pouring that off and then trying to cook it till it's cooked the whole way through and there's no red in the middle. And then we'll end up putting it in our duck corn noodle soup, which we'll show you how to make in just a sec. Alright, so we are just about done here. These are a little bit on the dry side, but we're just going to take a little bit of oil, stick it in there, just try to loosen them all back up a bit. But this looks great, and it's probably going to taste even better. Done a pretty good job of taking it from a raw and somewhat bloody breast meat into a nicely cooked and browned cubed soup meat.
So the cook says it's real good, real tender. Master Chef Herschel Miller here.
Beat that sucker to a pulp.
That was good.
Brady approves too.
We beat that sucker to a pulp, and let me tell you.
Yeah, well, that's what makes it good.
It made for some good.
Duck is a pretty tough meat, so I got to tenderize it.
Good duck. All right. Now, we'll leave that there. Next thing we got to do is take this crock pot, and we're going to add, for the duck corn noodle recipe, we're going to add Campbell's chicken noodle broth. With noodles. There is no chicken in this joke. I can only find a can of cook a lot better if it was like Rachel Ray and everything was like right there.
Yeah.
It took the first 15 minutes to find the spatula.
Rachel Ray spends a little more time.
Everything's already measured out in a bowl. All I gotta do is pour it in. It's not real cooking.
It's not real cooking. It's not cooking because she already measured it out before.
There's one chicken noodle broth.
Sharp Shopper brand, I'm guessing?
It's Sharp Shopper, it's Campbell's.
So what is that, 99 cents, right?
99 cents.
Yeah.
What? Anyhow, you may think we are rookies right now, but we're not. We do have to add water to this.
Oh, we know what we're doing. This isn't our first rodeo.
This is not our first rodeo. We've been through it before. There's two. And numero three. Corn, as you promised.
We got the corn.
For duck corn noodle. And man, I wish somebody would have let this thaw out, but...
Cream style corn. Yeah, and that's it. You're gonna need the hatchet.
Fine by me. Okay, we're good.
Proper kitchen utensils here at the farm.
A block. Okay, and there we go. Got some extra corn in there. And then the last thing we're going to do is take our ready-made duck that we just sauteed and shove it in there.
Oh, yeah.
And all you got to do after that is put a little in that junk. And we'll put that on low tomorrow morning when we go hunting. And by noontime, we'll have lunch. Duck corn noodle soup. Stick this back in the fridge. Dang it, there's no room in the fridge. That's how we pick some room. Stop. Yeah. That concludes cooking with Pennsylvania Outdoors Unlimited.